shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart, and when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Well, it sounds pretty good. In fact, that's just the right spirit. Our songwriters, Dick and Bob Sherman of the Walt Disney Studio. The Sherman brothers have written many of the wonderful songs for our motion pictures and television shows, and I think this song, written especially for you, captures the spirit of the General Electric Pavilion at the New York World's Fair. Thanks, boys.
Thanks, Walt.
Say goodbye to the folks.
Bye-bye.
Well, a beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away. That says we're going places. There's progress ahead. And that's just the mood we want for the whole pavilion. Here, for example, is a scale model of the General Electric Carousel Theater, a theater in which the audience itself moves in their seats around the stages. The actors, well, they're not real people, but they are a talented and interesting cast. We call them audio animatronic figures, and they talk and act like human beings. The Carousel Theater will present a warm and entertaining portrayal of how life has changed through electrical energy. The same kind of exciting and unique entertainment is what we're planning for every area of the General Electric Pavilion. So, see you at the fair, and remember,
there's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow.
Hello, I'm Rex Allen, and I had the honor of performing in that original show some 30 years ago. While the show has changed, its spirit of progress is a living tribute to the man who first created it, Walt Disney. Welcome to Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress. You may not know it, but this show was originally created for the 1964 New York World's Fair. Designed as part of the Progress Land Pavilion, Walt's idea for this show revolved around the idea of creating a warm and entertaining portrayal of how progress has made our lives better, from the turn of the century to the then modern day 1960s. Now, since visitors to the World's Fairs always expect to see the latest innovations, Walt created a revolutionary theater in the round where the audience literally moved around the stages and performers. And these were no ordinary performers either. They were the latest innovation in animation from Walt Disney, which he called audio animatronics. Walt and his Imagineers created a cast of 32 talented performers for the show. And what made these actors so unique is that they could perform nonstop all day long without ever taking a break. The whole cast was assembled for a dress rehearsal just 2 months before opening day at the fair. Walt and his crew had to work around the clock to get the show finished on time.
This is the stage for Act One of the Carousel Theater Progress. Stages for the other acts are being assembled at other places in the studio for a complete audio animatronic dress rehearsal. Now, this contraption here might look like something from outer space, but it's actually a control harness for programming the actions and gestures of our audio animatronic figures. Shall we show them how it works?
Really, Walt.
This is the Carousel Theater host. Whatever the man in the harness does, this figure will respond simultaneously in the same manner. Would you care for a light? I don't think we better. No smoking on the stage. You can, read the newspaper. How about showing how you read the newspaper? What's the date of that thing? 1890. The operator of the control harness has to be a bit of a ham actor, as you can see. Now, you know, all of the operator's actions are recorded on tape. Now let's hear the theme song of the Carousel Theater.
There's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. Since its debut at the 1964 New York World's Fair, the Carousel of Progress has been seen by more people than any other show in American history. I'm Rex Allen, and I had the honor of performing in that original show over 30 years ago. And while the show has changed over the years, it continues to entertain audiences today. An ongoing tribute to one man who never stood in the way of progress, Walt Disney.
Are you tailing me or something?
Oh, yes, you might say so. There's two things, Walt. First, Mrs. Disney called. She wants to know, since you didn't make it home for Christmas, do you think you can by Easter?
Tell her I doubt it, but I will see her at the fair.